Hi, everybody. CJ Murphy from EliteFTS.com and TotalPerformanceSports.com, bringing you another round of 44 and Broken. Right now, it's part five, week five, and it's a bench day, and it is a deload week. So I'm going to use the Elite FTS Swiss bar for three sets of eight in the floor press. Brian said to keep it light, so stuck with 185 and then worked up to 225. Nothing too heavy, nothing too crazy, just to get a little bit of work done. And we're going to show you my training partner, Jane, hits a huge PR today in the bench press. She is training for the World Championships coming up in Vegas. And as you may or may not know, I'm training for the RPS Power Challenge in October 21st in Attleboro, Mass. And right now, my buddy Hollywood Matt Murphy is doing a handoff, and I'd really like to thank him for wearing underpants today because it was a little bit uncomfortable with this portion of the workout for me. And if he was going commando, I probably would have had to pack it in and call the workout a day. So right now we're at 215, 205, something like that. Like I said, Brian said to keep it light. It's a deload week, and on Saturday I'm going to be going off the plan. Vincent DeCenzo from Elite FTS comes up to my gym once a month and does a bench clinic. So I'll be putting the shirt on and seeing if I can get him to fix some of the technique issues that I have. Right now we're going to see Jane Stabile. She's warming up. She's going to take 185 to a one board. And she's coming along very nicely on the bench. I expected a bench around 225 at the World Championships or more. She made that look easy. Would have liked to see her stay on the board a little bit longer, not jump the press command. And now back to me on the floor press with the Elite FTS Swiss bar. I like to use the Swiss bar a lot when I can. The neutral grip, the hand position, takes a lot of pressure off the shoulder and the biceps. And being as I have one extremely beat up shoulder and one extremely beat up bicep, benching with the straight bar tends to aggravate those. So this was a good choice for me. I also like the floor press too because it really, it helps with your bottom end strength, and I need as much help on the bottom as I can. Usually that's where my mistakes start to show. The head is coming off the belly, the butt will pop up or something will break. And on the heavier board work for me, usually I'm okay at lockout. So this is a good exercise for me. If you don't have a Swiss bar, you could also do this with dumbbells, with a neutral grip. Keep your shoulders from getting banged up. And we're going to head back over to Jane next. She is taking what looks to be 205. I don't remember what her weights were for the day. And we had some issues with her on the setup today. I didn't put all of those in the video. But she had some setup issues where on one or two of the sets she set up a little bit too far into the bench and hit the racks on the upright, so we moved her out a little bit to make sure that didn't happen on this set. And we're trying to get her to wait for the commands. Don't know if she waited for it there, but it looked a little quick to me. And now she's taking a little bit more weight. Like I said, I don't know what this is, but Jane's come a long way in her strength. She's a drug-free lifter. She's well over 50 years old, and she squats over 400. We're looking to get her to bench about 225 this time, and pulls over 400 in the 165s. And we use the man pawn here a lot. Brian wants us to use a half board, but I don't have a half board, and I'm not going to go and buy one or make one, so we just use the man pawn for that. Man pawn is basically a foam roller cut in half. Now I'm on to my assistance exercise. I did three sets of five light in the overhead press. I only filmed one set of each assistance exercise. Had a much better time on the overhead press today. The bicep was acting up a little bit. It's been feeling pretty good, but all the straight bar work on the bench and the squat has been kind of aggravated, so I was feeling it here. I like to call these the beard press. When things are going well, I usually get about an extra 30 pounds out of the beard. Wasn't really using too much today. It's good to get some rebound off of. But today it was more of a strict beard press. I don't know about you guys, but this was a deload week to me, and the deload weeks always seem harder to me than the high volume, high percentage weeks. I don't know if that's mental or if it's just that you really needed the deload. So right now we're going to see Jane with 225 to a two board, and we had a couple of technique issues. I left this in here so Brian could see it. Brian Carroll is her coach, and he analyzes the video. What she did on this set is she pulled the right shoulder in nice and tight on the bench, and she had the left shoulder pushed up pretty much as high as she could, and she didn't pull the shoulder in, and she had some issues with it, and we're going to have her take that again. You'll see that in a second. She does a much better job on that. We adjusted her shirt a little bit. She thinks the shirt may have been causing a problem, so we adjusted it, and she goes back after that in a second. Today, on my assistant's work, Brian loves band flies, and I had to do three sets of 20. I only filmed one set of those, but I stepped up to using an average band instead of a light band. Normally, I stretch the light bands out pretty far, and I used the average band today, and the difference in tension between the two is pretty amazing. And I'm also kicking it old school, early 90s style with that Dare t-shirt. Somebody dared me to wear that in a video. I'm getting a lot of requests to wear t-shirts in video, so if anybody wants to mail me a free t-shirt, that'll be a size 3X. You can send that to me at Total Performance Sports, 68 Vine Street, Everett, Mass. And we'll see if we can get it into the video. And right now I'm pumptastic. I felt so swole after three sets of those, I didn't know what to do with myself. And now we're going to see Jane on her last set. She's taking 225 again to the two board. And she does this for a double. She does a much better job this time. And as you watch, I'd just like to close out and say thanks to everybody for watching the videos. Thanks for all your support and all your comments on leadfts.com. And also, thanks to everybody at the gym that's helping me train, all my spotters, all the guys that are giving me handoffs. And one more time, a huge thanks to Hollywood Matt Murphy for wearing underpants as he was doing my handoffs today and not making things awkward. Read all the articles on EliteFTS.com that accompany these. Look for 44 and Broken in the article section. And stay tuned for more. Thanks.